हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम वंस अगेन ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल माइक्रोबायोलॉजी बाय संतोष नक्ते। फ्रेंड्स, टुडेज लेक्चर इज अबाउट द क्रोमैटोग्राफी। सो ऑल ऑफ यू नो दैट देर आर सो मेनी टेक्निक्स आर देयर इन लाइफ साइंसेस और वी कॉमनली इट कॉल्ड इट एज अ स्टडी ऑफ सच इंस्ट्रूमेंट दैट इज बाय इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन। एंड in my last lecture I have taken one video lecture on the pH meter, its principle, applications and working, and today I am taking this lecture on chromatography. So this is the first lecture on chromatography, so watch whole this lecture, and if you have not subscribed this microbiology by Santosh Napte, so kindly subscribe this channel so that you will get notifications of upcoming videos. So let's start with this chromatography lecture. Now in today's lecture we will see about the basic concepts which are related to this chromatography, because if you want to learn this chromatography then it is very essential to learn the or to understand the basic concept or basic terms related to this chromatography technique. So that's why we will understand or we will see these basic concepts here. For example, analyte, then we will see analytical chromatography, then we will see bonded phase chromatogram, then chromatograph, or which is also called as aerograph, then chromatography, then elevate, then eluent. Then next we will see heliotropic series. Then later on we will see what is meant by immobilized phase, what is meant by mobile phase. Then we will see retention time. Then we will see about the sample, what is meant by solute, what is meant by solvent. Then we will see what is meant by stationary phase. And lastly we will see what is meant by detector. So friends, all of these terms, these are the very important terms to understand the further knowledge of this chromatography. So let's start with the our main purpose, that is about the chromatography. So this chromatography means, actually this chromatography, it is derived from the two words. One is chroma, which is mean, that is means the color, and the another word is here, that is graphene, which means that is to write. So this chromatography, it is derived from the two words. One is chroma, means color, and graphene means to write. So this type of technique or this chromatography technique, it is first time used to separate the pigments. Pigments are nothing but the colored compounds or coloring compounds here. So that's why the name of this technique is given as a chromatography, which includes the color here, or that is to write the color. So here it is useful for use first time for the separation of pigments, therefore this technique is called as chromatography technique. This is developed by in Russia by Mikhail Twist in 1900, and at the same time he coined the term to this technique as a chromatography. And in the first decade of this 20th century this technique was used for the separation of plant pigments, which includes chlorophyll, then carotenes, as well as xanthophylls. So these are the plant pigments, that is chlorophyll, carotenes and xanthophylls, and in the first decade of this 20th century this technique is used for the separation of all these pigments. And these components, they are separated by using this chromatography in the bands of different colors. So there is a band formation will be there according to the type of component, or that we can see here pigments. For example, here green color band is obtained, then orange and yellow, and these bands, that is green, orange and yellow, they indicates the, or from this name they given the name as a technique, that is chromatography technique. Now we know that this is a biophysical technique, or it is a one type of bioinstrumentation technique here, and it is useful for the separation, identification and purification of the components of a particular mixture. So this is the main use of this technique, that is this chromatography technique, it is useful or it is used for separation, identification and purification of the component from the mixture. And this purification, it is generally qualitative purification, that is nothing but you are identifying which particular component is present in that mixture, that is qualitative separation or identification we can see here. And it is also a quantitative analysis, means here we are identifying the concentration or concentration of that particular substance in the mixture. So it means it is a quantitative analysis. So the mixture, it is dissolved in a fluid, whatever that mixture we are from which we are going to separate that particular components here. So that mixture, it is dissolved in a fluid, that may be gas, solvent or water. So this fluid in which that mixture is dissolved, it is called as mobile phase. And which this mobile phase, it carries that mixture through the system, which may be a column, which may be a capillary tube, which may be a plate, or it is a sheet. So on all these materials, that particular mixture, it is fixed, and or this particular material is fixed here, and that is called as the stationary phase. So this, now we know that chromatography, it consists of a that mobile phase, at the same time it consists of a stationary phase. The different constituents of that mixture, they have different affinities for the stationary phase, because whatever that components are present in that mixture, all these components, they have different affinities or attraction towards that particular stationary phase. And these different molecules, they stay longer or shorter duration on that particular stationary phase on the basis of their interactions with the sites of that stationary phase. So this depends on the that particular molecules here, for which time they get interacted with that stationary phase. Therefore they travel at a different velocities in the mobile fluid, and that's why there is a separation of that particular component takes place. So actually this is the basic principle behind this separation of these components by using this chromatography. So this separation, it is based on the differential partitioning between the mobile and the stationary phases. And that differences in compounds partition coefficient, it is actually result in differential retention on the stationary phase, and therefore it causes the separation of the component or that constituent. Okay. So now we will see this principle of chromatography. It means on which basis that components get separated from the mixture by using this chromatography technique. So these molecules which are present in the mixture, these are applied on the surface or into the solid and fluid stationary phase or a stable phase, that separating from each other while moving with the help of a mobile phase. So whatever that components or that molecules are present in that mixtures, firstly they are applied on the surface or into the solid and fluid stationary phase or stable phase, and later on they move with the help of this mobile phase. Now the factors which are responsible for separation process, that includes molecular characteristics. So whatever the components get separated here, so separation of such components, it depends on the some molecular characteristics of that mixture or that components here. For example, adsorption, that is liquid solid, then partition, that is liquid solid, and affinity or difference among their molecular weights. So these are some important characteristics we can see here, or molecular characteristics which are actually responsible for the separation process by using this chromatography. And because having these differences, there are some components are present in the mixture which stay for the longer duration in that stationary phase, and they move very slowly in the chromatography system, and there are some another substances are also there which passes very fastly or which moves rapidly into the mobile phase, and finally they leave that chromatography system, that is they get separated. So in this way there is a separation by using this chromatography techniques takes place. So here, as I told earlier, here there is a different phases are there. One is stationary phase, and this phase, it is composed of a solid phase. It is solid phase, or it is a layer of a liquid adsorbed on the surface solid support. So this is called that the stationary, and as the name suggests here, this stationary phase is a stable phase. Second part of that chromatography is the mobile phase. Mobile means here that is it can move from one place to another. We can say here, so this phase is always composed of a liquid or a gaseous component. And next component is here that is separated molecules. See, this is the diagram here. This is eluent here. Then later on it is the analyte. Then this is a column, or we can say a column chromatography. Then here it is a stationary phase. Then later on this is mobile phase. Here cotton pluck. Then it is the eluent. So these are the different components doing that, or which are involved in the separation process by using chromatography technique. See, this is the again another basic principle of this chromatography. See, this is the plant material which consists of different components we can see here, or different materials in which you are interested. This is the chromatography, we can say, or chromatography column here. So this is the paper chromatography example, and later on there is a separation of that components takes place according to their purity. So here these are the bands will be obtained, and particular band it indicates that particular component from the mixture. So in this way, with the help of this chromatography, there is a separation of components takes place from the given mixture. So next concept we will see, that is analyte. So the substance which is to be separated during chromatography. So what is analyte here? So analyte, it is a substance which is to be separated during the chromatography, and it is also a substance which is needed from the mixture. Suppose if there is a particular mixture is here, and in that mixture we are having this so many components. For example, these components are A, B, C, then there is a D. So these are the different components present in the mixture. So if you are interested to purify or separate in this B components, then this B, it can be a analyte for us. It is a analyte for us. So in this way, analyte, it is a substance which is to be separated during the chromatography, or it is also a substance which is needed from the mixture, because we are requiring this B substance from the mixture. So that's why it is a analyte. If you are interested in this A, then it is also a analyte. So that is analyte which is present in the mixture, or it is required from the mixture. Next concept is analytical chromatography. So this analytical chromatography, it is used to determine the existence or presence and possibly the concentration of analyte or analytes present in the sample. So in analytical chromatography, you are checking or you are determining the presence or existence of that particular analyte in the sample or in the mixture, or you are also finding out the concentration of that particular analyte. Then such type of chromatography, it is called as analytical chromatography. Now the next concept is bonded phase. So this bonded phase, it is a stationary phase, and it is covalently bonded to the support particles or to the inner wall of the column. So this bonded phase, it is actually a stationary phase, and it is covalently bonded to the support or support particles, or sometimes it get bound, or it is bound to the inner wall of the column. So then it is called as bonded phase. Next concept is chromatogram. So what is this chromatogram? So chromatogram, it is the visual output of the chromatograph, and in case of an optimal separation, there is a different peaks or different patterns on the chromatogram corresponds to the different components of the separated mixture. So this chromatogram, it is nothing but the visual output. Now whatever that, suppose after completion of that separation by using this chromatography, now whatever that results will be obtained here, so that will be your chromatogram, because it is a visual output. You can see the separated components here, so that's why it is a visual output. And in case of that optimal separation here, there is a different types of peaks or patterns will be obtained on this chromatogram, and these peaks or that pattern, these are corresponds to the different components. So whatever that peaks will be here, suppose here these are the peaks here, so that indicates particular type of components or it indicates particular type of substance present in that or separated from that mixture. So this is the chromatogram, and when it is plotted on the, so at that time on x-axis there is a retention time is indicated, and on the y-axis there is a signal is indicated. If you take the example that is which is obtained by the spectrophotometer or mass spectrometer or a different types of detectors, and this corresponds to the response created by the analytes present in the system. So whatever that peaks will be obtained on the chromatograph, that peaks, they are corresponds to the response created by or given by the analytes present in that particular chromatographic system. And in case optimal system, that signal, it is proportional to the concentration of the specific analyte separated. So this signal, it is proportional to the concentration of the analyte present in that mixture or which is separated. Okay, so here if the signal is more here, it means there is more concentration of that particular analyte is separated or present in the mixture. See, this is about the that peaks which are obtained here. So these peaks or these peaks, they indicate the particular substance or the of their concentration. Okay, see, this is the same diagram here. Next concept is eluate. So what is this eluate here? So eluate, it is the analyte material that emerges from the chromatograph, and it is specifically includes both the analytes and the solids passing through the column. See this diagram here. So this is the, here it is stationary phase, this is stationary phase, then this is eluate, and here this is the eluate. So this eluate, it is the analytic material and it is emerging from the chromatograph here, and it includes analytes as well as solids which get passed through this column here. Okay, and this process, it is called as the elution. So elution is the process of extracting one material from another by washing with a solvent, and as in washing of loaded ion exchange reagents to remove the captured ions. So when there is a, for example, in case of ion exchange chromatography, there is a, that molecules which is to be separated, they get attracted toward or they get captured by the ions, and when you will use their particular solvent for washing purpose, then that ions, they get, or that desired material or that substance, it get separated. Next concept is, that is eluent or eluent. So it is the carrier portion of the mobile phase, and it moves the analytes through the chromatograph. So whatever the analytes are present here, for example, that analytes, they are moved with the help of this eluent. So this is the eluent here, and it moves that particular substances. And in liquid chromatography, the eluent, it is the liquid solvent. Liquid chromatography mein eluent, it is the liquid solvent, and in gas chromatography, that eluent is the carrier gas, or simply it is a gas. So this is about the eluent or eluent. See here, this is the diagram here. So that auditorial eluent, it consists of the that desired material, and plus it consists of the solid particles also. Next one is here, eluotropic series. So what is this eluotropic series? So it is the list of solvents which is ranked according to their eluting power. So eluotropic series means here, it is a list of solvent which is ranked according to their eluting power, and this eluotropic series, it is a listing of various compounds in order to their eluting power for a given adsorbent. So, and this eluting power means here, eluting power of a solvent, it is a measure of how well the solvent can pull that particular analyte from the adsorbent to which it is attached. Okay, so this eluting power, it is a measure of how that particular solvent or that particular material, it pulls that analyte from the adsorbent to which it is get attached. And such type of eluting eluotropic series, it is very useful for determining the required solvents needed for the chromatography. See, this is the the table here. This is adsorption strength, least strongly here, and it is most strongly. So saturated hydrocarbons, alkyl halides, these are the, or they have least adsorption strength. But from here, that adsorption strength is increasing. So acids and bases, that is including amines, they have the highest adsorption strength. Okay, so less than these alcohols, then aldehyde ketones, this is the adsorption strength is decreasing in this way, or it is increasing in this way. Then later on, eluting power. So this hexane or pentane, it has the least eluting power, but the eluting power of these compounds, it is increasing from hexane or pentane to this water. So water, it has the highest eluting power. Okay, so this is about the eletrotropic series. Next concept is immobilized phase. So what is this immobilized phase? Immobilized phase, it is a stationary phase, and it is immobilized on the support particles or on the inner wall of the column QB. So that is called as immobilized phase. Then mobile phase. So this phase which moves in a definite direction. So mobile phase is a phase which moves in a definite direction, and it may be a liquid in liquid chromatography and capillary electrochromatography, or it may be a gas in gas chromatography or a supercritical fluid chromatography. Now this mobile phase, it consists of the sample. That mobile phase, it consists of the sample which is to be separated or which is to be analyzed, and it also consists of a solvent that continuously moves the sample through that chromatographic column. So this mobile phase, it is a gas or it is a liquid, and it moves that analyte continuously through the column. For example, in case of HPLC, or which is called as high performance liquid chromatography, the mobile phase, it consists of a non-polar solvent. For example, here hexane in normal phase, and it consists of polar solvent, for example methanol, in a reverse phase chromatography. And it also consists of a sample which is to be separated. Here the mobile phase, it moves through the chromatographic column, that is through the stationary phase, where that particular sample or that analytes, it interacts with this stationary phase and it gets separated. So in this way, that is actually the principle of chromatography here. So this is the mobile phase, the phase which passes over stationary phase, it is called as mobile phase, and it may be a liquid or it may be a gas, or it is also called as a eluent, because it is moving through the chromatography column. And examples of this mobile phase includes that alcohol, it is water, then ethanol, acetic acid, then acetone or gas. So these are the examples of mobile phase. See, this is the diagram here. See, here there is a loading of sample, that is mixture which is to be separated is dissolved in the mobile phase. So this is the mixture here, and it consists of different desired analytes, we can see here, or different desired components. So these are dissolved in the mobile phase. See, this is the, here this is the stationary phase here, and this is called as the chromatography column. Okay, here we can stopper cock, we can see here. So here mobile phase is added throughout the process. Continuously there is a mobile phase is added, and here these are the components which are to be separated here. See, these are the having different colors, we can see, or different, actually these are present in the mixture, but that mixture, it consists of different components. So here there is a components, for example, you can say A, components B and components C. Later on, as the time passes, so there is a separation of that component will be separate, occurs in the form of bands here. So each component is collected as it reaches to the bottom of the column, because it is moving through the with the help of mobile phase. So finally, these components, they collected in a separate tubes, we can see here, or in a flask. So in this way, there is a separation of this desired components or analyte from the mixtures, we can do with the help of this chromatographic technique. Then next concept is stationary phase. So stationary phase is a phase which becomes adsorbed on the filter media or a surface. Then it is called as stationary phase, or it may be a liquid, or it may be a solid. And the samples, examples include silica gel, then alumina, then filter paper, these are the examples of stationary phase. Next concept is sample. So sample, it is the matter which is to be analyzed in chromatography. It may consist of single component or it may be a mixture of components. So whatever the mixture we are having, we can call it as a sample. And that sample or that mixture, it is a mixture. So it consists of single components or it consists of many components. And we are interested one of that particular component, or sometimes we are interested all these components, or these are useful to us. So we will separate these components from the mixture with the help of this chromatography technique. Now when the sample is treated in a course of an analysis, then the phase or the phases containing analytes of interest is referred to as the sample, and the everything out of interest or in which we are not interested and separated from the sample before or in the course of that separation or during course separation, then it is called as waste material. Next concept is the solute. So the solute, it refers to the sample components in the partition chromatography. So whatever that components are present in the sample here, so we can call it as a solutes. Then solvent, that solvent, it refers to any substance capable of solubilizing another substance. So water, we know that it is a solvent because it is solubilizing the sugar, for example, we can take example, or it can solubilize the salt also. So solvent, it is any substance which have the ability to solubilize another substance, and especially in the liquid mobile phase in liquid chromatography, then it is called as solvent. And the next concept is here, that is detector. So this detector, it refers to the instrument which is useful for the qualitative as well as quantitative detection of analytes after separation. So this detector, as the name suggests here, it detects the component qualitatively as well as quantitatively, so present in the mixture. So that's why that instrument, it is called as a detector. So friends, here we have completed some basic, very important terms which will be useful for understanding the next points or types of chromatography. So watch this whole video, and if you have not subscribed this channel, kindly subscribe this Microbiology by Santosh Napte. So we will meet in next lecture with types of chromatography. Thank you.